Okay, we're continuing FF7. Tifa is waking up. Tifa is now our lead character. Huh? This is Barrett. The glare. Yeah, we are not used to the light. You'll be better soon. You've been asleep for a long time. I'm hungry. Hey, why don't you ask? Weird translation there, but you get the intent. About him. Ah, maybe not a weird translation. All right, we've gotten used to the glare. Because I'm scared. Right, because the first thing she said waking up wasn't what happened to Cloud. Don't worry, I don't know what happened to Cloud either. Guess I shouldn't tell you not to worry. None of them know if he's all right either. He's still alive, right? Now, he was left behind when we flew out on the Highwind, the airship, with Shinra. He was not, dragged out with them. Real bad stuff looked like it was happening there in the crater. We have no idea what shape he's in. And we do know what happened the last time we had our lead character, formerly Cloud, now Tifa, see someone run off in the distance, leaving us, formerly Eris, now Cloud. How long was I asleep? Well, let's see now. Must have been about 7 days. What about Sephiroth? You ain't over it yet. Remember that huge light in the northern cave? Since then, the crater's been surrounded by a huge barrier of light. Everyone knows Sephiroth sleeps in that big hole, protected by the barrier. Can't do a damn thing about it. We just gotta wait till he wakes up. And on top of that, some monster called Weapon's been on a rampage. There are five weapons, as we learned last time. Weapon? Remember that huge monster that was with Sephiroth at the bottom of the crater? Well, it's up here now. They say it's some legendary monster from the past. Weapon is protecting Sephiroth. Dunno, but he's up here going around tearing shit up. Right now, Rufus is fighting it. Hate to say it, but he's got guts. We should have been the ones to destroy it, but we ain't got no time. Time. Hey, how about Meteor? Classic in-game animation moving into cutscene. Now that's not how the sky's supposed to look. What's funny about some of the rest of the game is that Meteor is hanging over the planet, right? And we now could, if we choose, spend a lot of time doing like chocobo race type side quests as the game's like story is telling you this is unbelievably urgent. This has to be stopped immediately. You could go into the mode of, I am going to spend hundreds and hundreds of hours doing silly side quests. Do we have to give up? Dunno. Rufus redemption arc? I thought Cloud would show up to save you all. Professor Hojo wanted to check up on Cloud too. What are you going to do? What are you going to do to Cloud? Sephiroth's alter ego. Meteor has been summoned. Essentially, it's all but over now. So there's no need for you now. No, maybe there is an important task for you. President, preparations for the public execution are complete. This is not a Shinra redemption arc. Instead, it is a Shinra sees an opportunity for one last PR stunt, and they're gonna take it. They're gonna take it. Execution? What are you gonna get by executing us? You are to be executed for causing this situation. People are ignorant. They'll feel better as long as someone is punished. I take back what little praise I had for this damn jackass. Well, enjoy your last moments together. Gyahaha? I'll tie your arms now. No gyahaha yet. I'm disappointed in you, Heidegger. You've changed. All right, we now get a a walk to our execution. We try to go the wrong way. We're now Barret, not Tifa. We can't access the menu, which means we may as well, see if we can up our stuff. Yeah, let's do stuff that we're not going to be using on other characters on Barret, because may as well give him, like, decent power, right? We don't have, like, you know, I'm not going to give him the full loadout because I'd have to switch it off later, but, like, we may as well. I could save there. Probably should have. We'll save state. But I like, obviously, no cost to putting on equipment that I'm not going to put on anyone else, right? Not even being lazy cost. Alright. Classic Shinra. Is everyone here? These are the ones who brought this madness into the world. How are these people? We will be broadcasting your miserable deaths live on national television. Scarlet, why a public execution in this day and age? With the chaos resulting from the meteor reports, we desperately need to rally public support. It's better that we punish somebody. Anybody. That's not the kind of thing you want to say publicly. She's not great at this whole PR thing. You make me sick. Ha ha ha. They'll never admit it, but everyone loves this stuff. There is a history of people enjoying public executions. We'll start with this girl. Gotta do it. Do me first. Camera, this way. Make sure you get this. The audience just eats up tearful goodbyes. Scarlet, slightly villainous character, I would say. Is it death by electric chair? What are you doing? This is my special gas chamber. It is not. Take your time and enjoy a slow, painful death. Stuck up something. That's just rude. And extremely competent as a key drops out of a pocket. Well now, the show's about to begin. Emergency! Emergency! Weapons approaching! Attention all! Military personnel, take your positions. Oh no, it's weapon. Run! Yeah, what's gonna cause the end of the world first? Meteor, Sephiroth waking up, weapon destroying everything, one of the other weapons destroying everything. Hey, all of you. Damn, why now? How does it feel now, Scarlet? So you didn't run. I'm impressed. How do I feel right now? Huh? Sleeping gas. It was cait sith all along. Weirdo. And we have a battle. I think this might be just cait sith, not Barret, so I wish we could have changed his loadout. No, we do get Barret. That's wonderful. So Barret should be pretty high power. But I should have had him in the front row, because I did switch him on to a weapon that is only front row. These enemies are very weak, though. This will not be a problem. Oh, if their gunshots miss? Impressive to miss. It doesn't wake you up. I guess that makes sense, right? If you're put to sleep until someone hits you, and they, in fact, do not hit you. So they put the darkness ability on me there, which I believe has no effect whatsoever in this game because it is glitched. I think Piggy mentioned this in response to a video. Nice damage on that, especially considering he's in the back row. So you'll notice Barret has a punchy arm instead of a gun arm now, which is why he does only half damage from the back row. And he would do full damage from the front row. Again, their accuracy, not impressive. Classic Stormtrooper behavior here, I think. But we might have to wait a bit if they put us both to sleep. I'm just holding the confirm button. Nothing here that we can't punch through, but might take a little while. Maybe I should have put on an accessory to avoid sleep. Not sure if we had one. That'll wake both of us up, so that's lovely. But, you know, just gonna sit here. Eventually punching our way through. Bad accuracy, Barret. I think we should, if we remember, or if I remember, I'll put a Barrett front row. Oh, come on, man. Grenade, please. Let's use that handy dandy speed up button. Ah, there we go. I wish Barrett had a slightly higher accuracy. And again, if he was in the front row, he'd be doing 700. This would be substantially quicker. But yeah, man, we are gonna really up our damage output in the fairly near future. We're getting close. The plan's all coming to fruition. So if they let me between battles, I'm gonna change stuff, but I think we have to talk first. I'm here to help. This is when you untie Barrett's arms? I feel like that should have been before the battle, to make sense. Why are you? Ain't you part of Shinra? Let's just say I'm against capital punishment. Besides, I hate this broad. Come on, we gotta help Tifa. I'll keep watch at the entrance. I, too, am against capital punishment. And against this specific one. Fools. I've already pushed the switch. Oh no. Tug, tug. It won't open. That's bad news. What's Heidegger up to? Well, they have to deal with weapon, right? And they don't know that Barrett's broken free. It's weapon. There's been so many attacks lately. Can we handle it? I believe so. Your orders? No need to ask. We'll give it a shot from our big cannon. Junin does have a huge cannon. Open cannon doors. Activate cannon. Target weapon. And we did see this cannon early in the game. It's one of those many things where you get an early visual of something. Or like how they made sure we regularly saw the different villains, both the Turks, but also the head Shinra people like Scarlet and Heidegger. And Rufus, that everyone was brought back regularly to keep them in mind, and they were kept involved in the story. Similarly, when you come through Junin on the world map, and you also see it leaving when you're on the ferry, impossible not to notice the massive cannon. I think they do a really good job of making sure you've seen things before they have impact, making sure it feels like something that exists in the world. Preparations complete. The cannon. Fire! All right, who are you betting on? Cannon or weapon? Seems like a pretty impressive shot. And keep in mind, there are 5 weapons, so maybe one of them's like a total pushover, right? Well, that's very unclear. How'd we do? Did we get him? Seems so. Weapon approaching. Speed 50 knots. It's heading right toward us. Can't be. We hit it dead on. How about the cannon? It'll take time to reload. Then use regular firepower in the meantime. Yes, sir. Open all artillery doors. Target weapon. Don't let it land. Alright, more nice cutscenes here. Solid water effects. Improved in FF8, but pretty good here. Those hand bazookas I don't think are going to make the difference on this. Swimmy boy. Speed, 70 knots. Weapon, closing in. No good, it's attacking. Those lines of dialogue disappear fairly quick. Ah, come on, hand bazookas. This is going to be all the difference. That is not how targeting works on those, but that's okay. And then some of them just miss after doing the whole swoop thing to dodge the water. That was bad news. Because even if it doesn't hit, that water is going to be tidal waving in front of it. And Tifa's in a gas chamber. Gas. Barret, help. Hold your breath. Hold on as long as you can. Come on, I can't hold on forever. So we're going to have some controls for her to try to get to that key and get out. Shit. Alright, Barret can't do anything there. I don't think we had any more changes we wanted to make to our party. Wolves have already pushed the switch. Guess we gotta go the other way. The gas room's probably locked from a different room. Gotta go with a different plan. Let's get out of this room first. Tifa, I'll help you, I promise. We're gonna try. Actually, this is a kind of funny section to me. No, they locked this too. Because it's clearly like a sort of escape, rescue, all that kind of mission. And those are often exciting and feel tense. And this one has never felt particularly exciting or tense to me. Like, I'm not going to pretend to be worried about anyone because I never was worried about any one of these scenes. And I don't know. I think so much of the story works really well and hits like all the notes it wants to hit and more and does some really interesting things like I've been talking about. I think one of the main themes of this game is telling yourself the stories you want to hear. I think that's going to be a really important theme and has already been at times. But these themes here, this section, it's sort of this weird, we don't know what's happened to Cloud, and now we're dealing with kind of goofy Shinra shenanigans, like Scarlet's kind of a mean joke, right? This is played for yucks, right? Not played for very seriousness. And it always felt that way. Fools, now you can't save the girl. Ha 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 ha. God damn it. Okay, time for plan B. Let's run to the airport. Why the airport? And leave Tifa there. Trust me. We gotta take a chance. Alright. I don't think there's anything to the sides. Yeah, it won't let me go there. Where are you going? The airport's the other way. The airport, probably not this way, yeah. Same thing. And we'll go the proper direction now. Huh. Another reporter. The last reporter turned out to be cait. I wonder if this reporter, who looks suspiciously like a character we have some familiarity with. These guys always do more damage. Yeah. That also means we're going to limit break fast. And we did remember to put Barret in the front row, so his damage output is doubled. We only need Barret's level 1 limit. Oh, I forgot, we haven't even gotten his second limit yet. But his second limit eats MP. That's good damage. If we remember Red 13's limit. Now, he has some materia on, which lowers his power. Yeah, so Barret just got his second limit. It does MP damage, which is occasionally useful, but mostly not relevant. We'd rather just kill things by HP. I know you're in a hurry, but please, if I could have a word. Shut up! I'm in a hurry. Don't make so much noise. It's me, Yuffie. What the hell are you doing here? Sorry if I do too stereotypical a voice for Barret. It's hard not to read the kind of slightly AAVE, but slightly just southern lines without going into a slightly different voice. Anyway, I'll explain later. Now we got to get to the airport. I think I was doing a better job of it earlier. So we got third party member, another one we don't use in the party, don't have any new thing for her there, but what's something no one will ever use again? The gold armlet. That's a nice upgrade. And we'll just punch things. There won't be any need to do more than punch things. I think, generally speaking, this game has a good sense that, like, you're not going to be using your standard party here. Let's not throw anything particularly obnoxious at you. Just make it straightforward. Let you play. I appreciate that. We could probably back row Yuffie. I think Yuffie has full damage back row. It's been a long time since I used Yuffie. So. Sword of Doom. Ooh, that's bad. I don't think we've seen a cait sith's limit break yet. This guy seems to have a lot of life. But it's a roll 3 die, 1, 4, 6, and it does 1100 damage, 1 plus 6 plus 4 times 100. Probably should heal someone. Never had many Phoenix Downs. So let's high potion on cait sith and high potion on Barret. In fact, maybe another high potion on Barret. Missed. Oh, well, that was the better one to put it on anyway. Alright, keep us in range where Sword of Doom does not kill us. I think that's Barret. And we should Big Shot, not Mind Blow. And I think this will do about 5,000 damage against, unless it was like a crit, but I don't think these crit. Oh, they do. They must have crit. Okay, interesting. So his damage not that much better than Nanaki's. He just got a crit. You always forget between game to game which ones have which effects on things. Alright, we made it to the airport. Now ride this thing up. Head to the airship. Nice looking airship. I feel like after the last two episodes where so much plot happened, this one feels like such a, like, is there much meaning in this? It's fine. Yo, you sure this is the right way? It's a dead end. Uh-oh, did I make a wrong turn? You damn cat. What the hell are we gonna do now? They'll all be coming soon. Yo, better watch my back till the end, partner. Barret's big stand for humanity. Alright. Move your feet and arms, then use your head to get out of the chair. Oh no, I don't know which button's which. Legs, right. We definitely want to start with legs. Nope, we already did legs. Nope, don't need to do that again. And then... try different patterns, try and combine two movements at once. Yeah. That one's head. Want to do. There we go. It's just figuring out what on my keyboard is what. So now use the key on the other hand, and we're free, but we're still stuck. Which button stops the gas? I feel like it's this one. Gotta be still pretty bad for you. We get out the door, open it. Just gonna be trapped and starve. That's not great. And we're back to weapon. Weapon's turn to attack. What you got? Okay, it's generic mouth laser. Not impressed. Ooh, right in the face. Decapitated. One weapon down, four to go. Well done to the Junin cannon. A Other weapons will be more impressive. What'd you do? Hey, open it. First you lock me in this weird place, and now you're telling me to come out. Make up your mind. Luckily, that one laser mouth shot made an escape for Tifa. Very helpful. I think we're supposed to go down. Seems unlikely we'd want to be climbing up at this point. And got away from the Shinra guards. Got to get away from. Oops. They're not so good at climbing. Again, this is very much, like, not played seriously, right? We have, ooh, we shouldn't fall like that. But we have the, you know, multiple fake reporters played for laughs. Scarlet is the villain of this section, who is just not a very serious villain. You know, the scene could have been, these scenes could have been written very differently than they are. Don't mind it at all. I don't know if this needed to be a serious part of the game. But it's so weird, as the player doesn't know what happened to Cloud, to, like, not aim for this scene being tense. I don't know. Maybe that was very intentional. Maybe it was kind of, the player will be worried about their main character, so we're going to make this part worried about the others, not at all worrisome, because it's not really the issue. A little game of hide-and-seek ends here. There wasn't much hiding, just kind of running and seeking. The execution may have been unsuccessful, but your death by falling from here and crashing into the water below still might be pretty exciting. Tifa doing just a standing there like, eh, no big deal. Stuck up to the end. Quit slapping me, you old wench. And now we're in a slap-off because this game is very strange. Like, I was talking earlier about silliness in these games. Like, there's so many scenes like this, and it's a very strange, and I think this one isn't my favorite, but an amusing set of things to add to a game. God, I can't stand it. Take her away. Now it's time to pay up. I'll really drop you if you don't settle down. Ha 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 ha. Run. Run to the end of the cannon. We can do that. Classic in-game graphics into cutscene graphics as well. I think we've got ourselves an airship. That rope doesn't go far enough, I don't think, but okay. Great jump with those hands that FF7 character models have. But we made it, and we made off with an airship. So this was a very profitable way to get captured for a while. A lot of cutscenes in this section. There's a couple things we can go do now that we have the high wind. And I think we might do a few of them. Also, we can go anywhere much easier than we've been before. You okay? Actually, I think this will probably just be a stopping point. My cheek hurts a bit, and we will have fun using the high wind in the very near future.